आप लोग चैट बॉक्स में आंसर दे सकते हो. यू कैन राइट एम ई मी इन द चैट बॉक्स इफ यू आर न्यू फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. रंजिता ओके. सो दिस इज द सीरीज वेयर वी आर कवरिंग द एंटायर वन ईयर करंट अफेयर फ्रॉम मे 2019 टू अप्रैल 2020. वी आर कवरिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग द एमसीक्यूज, वी आर डिस्कसिंग द फैक्ट्स एंड वी आर इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर विच इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ द economy, right? After that we will start another chapters. So we have this session for approximately minimum 1 hour to maximum 1.5 hour. Apart from this session we also have the mains classes for the GS2, GS3 and apart from that we also have some homework. So main aapko classes mein homework deta hun. You do the homework and I ask the MCQ. The purpose is to ensure the discipline in your preparation. So those people who are interested to bring the self discipline, they can attend the classes and at the end of the class I ask you the certain questions from the homework. There are some ground rules for participation in the class. You should keep participating by answering into the chat box. So these classes will be interactive. I will keep asking you the MCQs. You will get lot of practice. And daily the timing we so far we have taken is 11 a.m. today we have started at 10 a.m. It is better if you have a notebook and pen. The PowerPoint presentations will be uploaded in the Telegram group. The Telegram group is this @IAS Economy. You can join this Telegram group. Daily at 4 p.m. we are having these classes, GS2, GS3, mains current affairs. So as of like till now, so far we have covered the monetary policy related developments. The video of this session is already on our YouTube channel par hamari video hai. The link of YouTube channel I will post on the Telegram channel, right? Then Basel norms we have discussed in detail. We have discussed the NPA related initiatives in detail. Central bank guidelines we have discussed some of them, but we will discuss more of them today. And then we will discuss all these topics टुडे. आज हम ये सब चीजें टॉपिक डिस्कस करने वाले हैं, राइट? सो दिस इज द एजेंडा ऑफ टुडे. सो स्टार्टिंग विद द आरबीआई गवर्नेंस एंड द फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन. सो फर्स्ट प्लीज गिव द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. द क्वेश्चन इज ऑन योर स्क्रीन. योर टाइम स्टार्ट्स नाउ. यू हैव नेक्स्ट 30 सेकेंड्स. सो इन द 30 सेकेंड्स यू हैव टू गिव द आंसर. सो प्लीज गिव द आंसर इन द चैट बॉक्स. Answer should be given in the private chat box, not to everyone. So whenever you are typing something, you will get a choice. Either you can send to everyone or you can send to me privately. So you have to choose IAS preparation, right? Please choose IAS preparation and send me privately. The purpose of sending private is that other people, they don't get disturbed by the messages and they have their own independent opinion about the answer. तो उनकी जो अपनी ओपिनियन है वो इंडिपेंडेंट रहे, ये भी एक पर्पस है, ठीक है? Ranjita, please give the answer. Rafiq, Ashish Dev, Hitesh, everyone, please give the answer. Preet, even if you are studying this topic for the first time, try your best. Give the answer. The purpose is that you participate. Saurabh, Subhajit, मुट्टू, सहुकार, प्लीज गिव द आंसर एवरीवन. Okay, if you are totally unaware, then you can write no. So I will get to know that you do not know about the topic, but I should get a feeling that you are here in the session participating in the quiz. ये मुझे पता चलना चाहिए. That is why you should write something in the chat box, right? Okay, good, Ashish. Shubhajit, very good. Okay, great, wonderful. So the answer to this question is option C, both A and B. ठीक है. So let us see this topic. We will discuss this topic in detail now. So basically, there has been a lot of controversy about the surplus of the Reserve Bank of India. So this topic is in the context of that controversy only. So during last 2 years, there has been a lot of controversy. So if we see Reserve Bank of India, Reserve Bank of India, that is a central bank, it was constituted in 1935, and at that time it was under the private ownership. In 1949, after the independence, this bank was nationalized. What is the meaning of nationalization? That means now the owner of this bank is the government of India. Owner kaun hai? Government of India. Now this RBI is earning its income from various sources. So what are the sources of income of RBI? Bahut sare source hai income ke. The sources include, for example, it earns the income from investment. So commercial bank, they deposit the money with the RBI. जो commercial bank होते हैं वो RBI के पैसे जमा करते हैं in the form of CRR. आपको पता होगा, cash reserve ratio. This money is with the RBI and RBI can invest this money anywhere. So this is one source of income. Apart from that, it has various reserves in the stock. तो RBI के पास में gold होता है, RBI के पास में आपका foreign exchange होता है, for example dollar, euro. So it has various foreign currencies. बहुत सारी foreign currency भी RBI के पास होती हैं, ठीक है? So the prices of these foreign currency can also increase. ये जो foreign currency है, इनका price बढ़ सकता है, ठीक है? Similarly, the RBI can also have investment into the government security. So the government usually borrows from the RBI. Apart from that, the RBI can also give the advance in the form of कौन कौन से एडवांस दे सकता है? Do you remember? आप लोगों को याद है? Who will like to give the answer? Which kind of advance can be given by the RBI to the central government? There is a technical term. We discussed that thing in detail during one of our session. एक session में हम लोगों ने बहुत detail में discuss किया था. So I would like to know from you, what is the meaning of that advance? Okay, good. Shubhajit, very good. The name is ways and means advance. Very good, right? तो ways and means advance पे कितना interest होता है? Who will tell me? How much interest? What is the rate of interest? Who will tell me? Ways and means advance पे कितना interest होता है? How much interest is given by the central government to the RBI? So I am trying to just interlink the topic. It's a kind of revision of the other topics. Okay? साहित्य को नहीं पता? कौन बताएगा? Three Ashish Dev, what is 3%? 3.5%. No. Okay. So 3% तो कहीं फिक्स नहीं है. मैंने कुछ और बताया था. कौन बताएगा मुझे? Who would like to tell? So basically the rate is very simple. That is the repo rate. आपको पता होगा जो ways and means के एडवांस होते हैं वो repo rate पे होते हैं. और अगर ये एक्सटेंड हो जाते हैं बियॉन्ड 90 डेज, देन इट इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू द ओवरड्राफ्ट एंड देन 2% एक्स्ट्रा इज पेड. ठीक है? सो दिस इज द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. चलिए, ग्रेट. सो these are the various sources of income of RBI. ये बहुत सारी sources हैं. Now RBI is earning this income every year. इस तरह की income जो है वो हर साल earn कर रहा है. And now out of this, these item number 2 and 3, they are basically, if I say what is the income on them, the change in the price of gold or change in the price of foreign exchange reserve, that is nothing but the change in the value of assets. Change in the value of assets. So this change in the value of asset, this is called revaluation profit. इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? Revaluation profit, right? So this is called revaluation profit. Okay. Okay, I get it. How many of you are watching the lecture on the mobile phone? Mobile phone pe kitne log dekh rahe hain? So best experience comes on the laptop. I will suggest please use the laptop, because if you see in the laptop, you have a full screen. It is better view, hai na? So thoda sa comfort zone se bahar aaiye. Because main jab kuch corner mein likhta hu, to some of you ask me, don't write in the corner. So that's why I'm saying please open the laptop, it is better. But anyways, I will accommodate your request. So gold, foreign exchange reserve, the value of these two things is changing. Inki jo value hoti hai wo change hoti rehti hai, theek hai? So the change in the value is called revaluation. Isko hum kya bolte hain? Revaluation bolte hain. And when we keep accumulating this revaluation amount from the past years, that is called revaluation balance. Usko hum kya bolte hain? Revaluation balance ya revaluation reserve bolte hain, right? So this is one kind of profit. So ye jo income hoti hai, agar RBI is under the ownership of government of India, this income belongs to whom? This income belongs to the government, because our central government is the owner of the RBI. Therefore this income of the RBI belongs to central government. Now this income belong to the central government, does it mean that central government should give the amount to the RBI? Bhai ye jo income hai ye government of India ko jani chahiye, kyunki government of India hi malik hai RBI ka. Kya iska matlab ye hai ki RBI har saal sara ka sara jo bhi surplus hai, जो भी इनकम है वो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट को दे दे? नहीं, ऐसा नहीं हो सकता. अगर कोई सरप्लस है, इफ देयर इज सरप्लस, इट कैन नॉट बी गिवन एवरी ईयर टू द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, बिकॉज आरबीआई नीड्स समथिंग एज द बैकअप फॉर सम इमरजेंसी, फॉर सम अनफोर्सिन सिचुएशन. आरबीआई को कुछ इमरजेंसी के लिए, अनफोर्सिन सिचुएशन के लिए कुछ अपने पास में रिजर्व रखना होगा, ठीक है? Now the controversy arises. यहां पर controversy arise होती है. Government कहती है कि हमें पैसा दो, please give us the dividend. हम dividend, what is the dividend? Dividend means share in the profit. तो central government is saying please give us the share in the profit. And RBI is saying if I give you the share in the profit, if I don't keep anything with me, then how will I manage my work? अगर इफ टुमारो समथिंग हैपेंस टू द बैंकिंग सेक्टर, फ्रॉम वेयर आई विल मैनेज द फंड? सो दिस कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी बिटवीन द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया एंड द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ये रहती है, क्योंकि सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट चाहती है कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा पैसा आरबीआई से मिले और सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट उसको अपने कहीं भी उसको यूज कर सके, ठीक है? सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज डिमांडिंग द मनी फ्रॉम द आरबीआई, आरबीआई इज डोंट वांट टू गिव, सो देयर इज ऑलवेज अ कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी. टू रिजोल्व दीज कॉन्ट्रोवर्सीज, देयर हैव बीन मेनी कमिटीज सेटअप इन द पास्ट. पास्ट में बहुत सारी कमिटीज अलग अलग सेटअप होती रही हैं, ठीक है? सो टू साइज द आइडियल साइज ऑफ द टू डिसाइड द आइडियल साइज ऑफ द आरबीआई रिजर्व. रिजर्व का मतलब कि कितना सरप्लस आरबीआई अपने पास रखे, हाउ मच सरप्लस आरबीआई शुड कीप विद इटसेल्फ. टू डिसाइड दिस इशू, देयर हैव बीन 3 कमिटीज इन द पास्ट, वी सुब्रमण्यम कमेटी, उषा थोराट कमेटी एंड वाई एच मालेगाम कमेटी. ये 3 कमेटी अभी तक आरबीआई ने बनाई और as of now, at present, RBI is continuing with the recommendation of the Subramaniam panel, and RBI panel did not accept the recommendation of other. June 18 mein RBI ke paas jo reserve the wo 9.59 lakh crore the. This is a very very big amount. Theek hai, ab central government ke paas fiscal deficit hai. What is the meaning of fiscal deficit? Fiscal deficit means the total expenditure of the central government is more than the total receipts of the central government, right? So central government ke paas mein fiscal deficit hai. So because of the fiscal deficit, the central government want to receive some money from the from the RBI. ठीक है, so total money with the RBI is as on June 2018, 2 years ago, 2 साल पहले total जो पैसा था currency and gold revaluation में आपका इतना पैसा था. तो I already told you that prices of the gold and prices of the dollar etc. they keep fluctuating. So because of the fluctuation, there is some revaluation. So this revaluation is kept in a separate account. That account is called revaluation account. Then what is the contingency fund? So contingency fund is a certain percentage of profit, certain percentage of profit which the RBI keeps for some unforeseen situation. कि कोई भी future में if something happens in the future where there will be requirement of money, तो हम लोग इस पैसे को use कर लेंगे. ठीक है, so just like any common person keeps some extra money in the bank account, that if there is some emergency in the family, we can use this money. Similarly, this RBI also keeps this contingency fund for meeting its various emergency requirement. ठीक है, तो government ने बोला कि आप हमें इस 9.5 लाख करोड़ से 3.6 लाख करोड़ पैसा दे दो, please give us this money. तो गवर्नमेंट को लालच आ गया. ठीक है ना, तो वहीं से कंट्रोवर्सी का जन्म हुआ. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट कंट्रोवर्सी द बिमल जलान कमेटी वाज सेटअप. बिमल जलान कमेटी जो है वो सेटअप हुई. ठीक है, सो बिमल जलान कमेटी वाज सेटअप. नाउ बिफोर वी स्टार्ट डिस्कशन अबाउट दिस कमेटी, वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड सम टेक्निकल टर्म्स. हमें कुछ टेक्निकल टर्म्स समझने होंगे. आफ्टर दैट ओनली वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ द बिमल जलान कमेटी रिपोर्ट रिकमेंडेशंस. ठीक है, so first we have to understand what is the meaning of economic capital framework. ठीक है, so please now please I want to ask you one question. If you have any question till now, please ask me in the chat box. अगर आपको कोई सवाल है अभी तक जो भी मैंने discussion किया, because it is already 20 minutes we started the discussion, so in the last 20 minutes if anyone is having any doubt, please ask me. Otherwise I will continue discussing the rest of the things. Otherwise मैं बाकी की चीजें discuss करता रहूँगा. ठीक है, any doubt in the chat box you can ask, or you just write no no so that I get to know that you don't have any doubt, right? Because this is something conceptual. Sir, last point of amount ka repeat karna. Last point ke andar sirf ye hai, RBI has 9.59 lakh crore of surplus, out of which 6 point something lakh crore is in the revaluation account and rest amount is in the contingency fund. So total जो surplus है वो 9 point some lakh crore है. RBI want to this central government want to take a portion from this surplus, क्योंकि central government बोलती है कि हम आपके मालिक हैं, we are the owner of you, so please give us the money, right? RBI is saying I cannot give the money because I need this money for taking care of the emergency requirement. So this is a controversy between the RBI and the central government. चलिए, great, thank you very much. Now coming to the इकोनॉमिक कैपिटल फ्रेमवर्क. ठीक है, इकोनॉमिक कैपिटल फ्रेमवर्क क्या होता है? सो फ्रेमवर्क इज बेसिकली, दिस फ्रेमवर्क एक्चुअली प्रोवाइड्स द मेथोडोलॉजी. इट प्रोवाइड्स द मेथोडोलॉजी फॉर डिटरमाइनिंग द एप्रोप्रिएट लेवल ऑफ रिस्क प्रोविजन एंड प्रॉफिट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. रिस्क प्रोविजन क्या है? कि हाउ मच मनी आरबीआई शुड रिटेन विद इटसेल्फ इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सरप्लस फॉर any kind of risk that might arise. तो हम लोगों ने बात की थी contingency fund की, revaluation reserve की. ठीक है, तो that is risk provision, that how much money RBI should retain with itself and how much profit RBI should distribute to the central government. This methodology is decided as per the economic capital framework, and there is section 47 of the RBI Act, which under which central bank is required to pay balance of its profit to the central government. So as per the law, agar hum baat kare kanoon kya hai, because RBI is set up under the law. RBI is already under a law. It is a statutory organization. It is a law. It is under a law. It is a statutory organization. So in this law only, it has been clearly mentioned that central bank will be paying its profit to the central government, but after making the provision for bad and doubtful debts, depreciation in assets and contributions to staff. Now this is important. Provision for doubtful and bad and doubtful debts. That iska matlab ye ho gaya ki suppose RBI has invested the amount in the some security. Kisi bhi security mein amount invest kiya hua hai, the value of that security can come down. So we have to keep some profit to set off the loss which arises because of decrease in the value of such security, or depreciation in the asset. That means decrease in the value of asset. Koi bhi asset hoti hai, for example, it is a building. So the value of the building keep decreasing. Koi bhi building jo hoti hai, uski value kam hoti rehti hai na time ke saath mein. Jab wo banti hai aur jab uske 10 saal baad, 20 saal baad, uski value dheere dheere kam hoti rehti hai. To uske liye bhi RBI apne paas mein profit rakh sakta hai, जिससे कि उस बिल्डिंग का फ्यूचर में हम वापस से बना सकें. कंट्रीब्यूशन टू स्टाफ, जो स्टाफ है उसको भी कंट्रीब्यूट कर सके. सो दिस इज द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ लॉ. लॉ ऐसा बोलता है, ठीक है. सो इकोनॉमिक कैपिटल फ्रेमवर्क, इट रेफर्स टू द रिस्क कैपिटल रिक्वायर्ड बाय द सेंट्रल बैंक व्हाइल टेकिंग इनटू अकाउंट डिफरेंट रिस्क. तो क्या क्या रिस्क हो सकते हैं आरबीआई के? इट कैन बी द मार्केट रिस्क. मार्केट रिस्क बेसिकली मींस द अमाउंट इट हैज इन्वेस्टेड इनटू वेरियस securities or gold or foreign exchange reserve, the value of all those things can come down. Second risk can be its credit risk. Credit risk bhi ho sakta hai, theek hai. Credit risk mein kya ho sakta hai ki jo bhi isne paisa kisi bank ko advance diya hai. So if RBI has given some advance to any bank, it is possible in the future that bank may not be able to repay the amount to the RBI. To aisa ho sakta hai ki suppose आरबीआई ने पीएमसी को पैसा दे दिया, पीएमसी को पैसा दे दिया और पीएमसी अब बैंकरप्ट हो गया, तो पीएमसी पैसा वापस नहीं दे पा रहा, तो ये भी एक रिस्क हो सकता है. थर्ड रिस्क कैन बी ऑपरेशनल रिस्क. एक ऑपरेशनल रिस्क भी हो सकता है, ठीक है. सो आरबीआई इज इनटू नॉर्मल ऑपरेशंस, उन ऑपरेशंस में भी कुछ रिस्क हो सकता है, ठीक है. सो इकोनॉमिक कैपिटल फ्रेमवर्क, इट रिफ्लेक्ट द कैपिटल दैट द इंस्टीट्यूशन रिक्वायर और नीड टू होल्ड as a counter against unforeseen risk or event or losses. तो जितने भी ये market risk है, credit risk है, operational risk है, इसकी वजह से जो भी loss हो सकता है, उस loss को counter करने के लिए RBI के पास में कुछ ना कुछ risk provision होने चाहिए, कुछ ना कुछ risk capital होने चाहिए, और इसी को calculate करने के लिए हमारा economic capital framework होता है, ठीक है. इसी को calculate करने के लिए हमारा economic capital framework होता है. Now, what is the meaning of economic capital? So this is basically economic capital. Economic capital का meaning क्या होता है? Economic capital of a central bank includes its capital, reserves, risk provisions, and revaluation balances. ठीक है? So now let us see each one of them. हम एक-एक की बात करते हैं. Capital. Capital का मतलब हो गया कि the amount which has been invested into the RBI by the central government. तो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने आरबीआई में जो भी पैसा इन्वेस्ट किया होगा वो उसकी कैपिटल हो गया, ठीक है. रिजर्व. रिजर्व मींस पास्ट प्रॉफिट. जो पास्ट में प्रॉफिट हुए उसका जो पोर्शन आरबीआई ने अपने पास रिटेन किया, दैट पोर्शन ऑफ पास्ट प्रॉफिट व्हिच हैज बीन रिटेन बाय द आरबीआई विद इटसेल्फ, दैट इज रिजर्व. रिस्क प्रोविजन. आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट देयर कैन बी वेरियस टाइप ऑफ रिस्क with the RBI. So RBI keeps certain percentage of profit with itself to meet such kind of risk. So that is called risk provision, right? Market risk, credit risk, operational risk, सारे तरह के risk को meet out करने के लिए. Revaluation balances, वो भी मैंने आपको बता दिया कि they can be change in the value of gold, foreign exchange reserve, or any other security. So the change in the value of those can lead to revaluation, so that is called revaluation balances, right? So revaluation balances means unrealized gains and net losses from movement of exchange rate and all that. Note that revaluation balances are major component of economic capital. तो आपको ये important बात है कि revaluation balances हैं, they form around 73% of the total economic capital of the RBI. तो RBI की जो economic capital है, उसका 73% जो पैसा है, वो revaluation balances से आता है, ठीक है? Now I told you that controversy arose between the central government and the RBI. To resolve this controversy, Bimal Chalan Committee was set up. So this committee had certain mandate. क्या mandate था? ठीक है? And before that, let me tell you किस तरह के questions पूछे जा सकते हैं. Prelims के लिए क्या important है? जो भी हम discuss कर रहे हैं, उसमें prelims के लिए क्या important है? So from the point of view of prelims, they can ask what is the meaning of economic capital. They can ask what is the meaning of economic capital framework. They can ask what is the meaning of section 47 section, or they can ask about Bimal Jalan committee, or they can ask about any of these three committee, V Subramaniam committee, Usha Thorat committee, YH Maligam committee, right? So these are the possible questions from the prelims examination point of view. This topic is very, very important because this topic has been in news for a long period of time. ये एक बहुत बड़ी controversy रही है. ये एक बहुत बड़ी कंट्रोवर्सी रही है, इसलिए ये टॉपिक तो बहुत बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है आपके लिए समझना, और एग्जाम में क्वेश्चंस बिल्कुल आ सकता है, ठीक है? नाउ कमिंग टू द बिमल चलान कमेटी. बिमल चलान कमेटी इसी के लिए सेटअप की गई थी. पर्पस क्या था? इट विल रिव्यू द करंट प्रोविजंस एंड रिजर्व्स ऑफ आरबीआई विज़ेविस अदर सेंट्रल बैंक. ये देखेगी कि इंडिया में हम लोगों ने कितना रिजर्व रखे हुए हैं और इंडिया के बाहर कितना रिजर्व रखे हुए हैं. सो अबाउट दिस if I see recommendation, what was the recommendation? So recommendation was that in various central bank outside India, jo foreign central banks hain, their methodology is not, you know, uniform. Unki koi methodology uniform nahi hai. That depends upon their relationship with the central government and their ownership structure. Ki kuch central bank ka ownership structure mein private sector bhi ho sakta hai. Accordingly, their reserve capacity, their profit distribution policy is changing, right? So, इसके बारे में ये recommendation थी. Suggesting appropriate risk assessment methodology and risk level of risk provisioning. कि कितना पैसा RBI को अपने पास रखना चाहिए. Determining whether RBI is holding reserve in surplus or deficit. कि RBI के पास जो पैसा है, वो extra है या कम है? इस चीज को calculate करना. And proposing a suitable distribution policy. ठीक है? Committee gave its report and these are the major points of report. ये major points हैं और बहुत सारे point हैं, लेकिन हमारे लिए important नहीं है. Technical point है, हमारे लिए UPSC के लिए important नहीं है. Committee proposes transfer of RBI reserve to government in tranches over 3 to 5 years. तो committee ने बोला कि अगर profit transfer करना भी है तो उसको single year में ना करके we can transfer in 3 to 5 years. So that RBI is also not facing any kind of shock. It recommended transferring of fund from both contingency and revaluation reserve. तो दोनों ही जगह से RBI जो है पैसा भेजेगा. And there should be period review of the RBI capital framework. So this methodology should be reviewed from time to time. ये जो methodology है, ये time to time आपकी review होनी चाहिए, right? So the answer to this question is ऑप्शन, बोथ ऑप्शन ए एंड बी. तो इकोनॉमिक कैपिटल फ्रेमवर्क, इट प्रोवाइड्स द मेथड फॉर डिटरमाइनिंग द एप्रोप्रिएट लेवल ऑफ रिस्क, एंड एज पर सेक्शन 47 सेंट्रल बैंक हैज टू पे द बैलेंस आउट ऑफ इट्स प्रॉफिट आफ्टर मेकिंग प्रोविजन फॉर वेरियस थिंग्स. ठीक है? सो द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन ए एंड बी बोथ. सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर यू. यू शुड नॉट इग्नोर दिस टॉपिक, राइट?